your mom and dad. Your mom and dad. Your mom and dad. Your mom and dad.
Well, welcome home, family. It's your mom and dad. Hello, hello, family. It is Fantasy Suite week this week. It is Fantasy Suite week, and I'll be completely honest with you. All I can think about is if I was currently in the Fantasy Suites, what my current dream would be is for the person to take me straight to the bedroom, for us to get in bed, and then go to sleep, because daylight savings is kicking my butt right now.
I'm wrecked right now. I'm full jet lag.
Dude,
what is going
on?
1 hour, and I am just like
all the 22-year-olds that are like, it's like they wake up at 1 p.m. They're like, honestly, I haven't even noticed it. Like the 1 to 12 difference has not really messed with me.
Hey, listen, the one to twelve difference does mess with you if that's what sleep you're getting and your body needs. When you were 21, you needed so much energy. What are you even talking about? You know, you need to be spry and young.
You know, they're talking. You know how they say when you get older, you need less sleep.
That is so wild to me. Like, who
still that still has not hit me.
I don't believe whatever scientist said that, whatever doctor. I believe whatever, in that case, whatever mind surgeon Evan says.
Yeah,
I believe
that was that was a mind surgeon, I'll be honest with you, that said that. For sure, that was a mind surgeon.
Mind surgeon 100%
That was some dude on a podcast in 1938 being like, I don't think you need it.
Because I'm like, yeah, every person who's older, like all of our parents and grandparents are like, yeah, no, I only sleep like 3 hours every night, but they're so tired. It's like their body isn't letting them sleep, but they want to
sleep. Maybe that's why they're old, because they started getting less and less sleep over the years, convincing themselves. But if we actually just slept a lot all the time, we'd stay young forever.
Wow.
Mind surgery. That's mind surgery 101. That's my first class is living forever.
You just sleep. I mean, I'd be down. Ideas. I'm like, if I could get a solid 12 baths in a day and a solid 12 hours, I feel like I'd be young for forever.
I love that idea. I remember my grandma would go to bed and then get up at like she stayed at our house a couple times, and I remember she would get up at like 3:30 and like start reading.
Yeah.
In the dark, and I was just like, that's crazy.
Yeah, it's so wild. My parents, or my dad and my stepmom, do that.
They get up real early.
Yeah, before the sun. You know what I mean? Like so early. But and then they don't go to bed that early either. So
that's
they
gotta just
get
be
a couple
anxiety.
Hours.
There's no way they want to be up that early. It's got to be some sort of like feeling of like you gotta get to work.
Now I did go to school with this one girl who was like, you know what, we were in college, so we were like 18, 19, and she only needed like 2-3 hours of sleep. Mm. Everyone in her family was like that too.
Yes.
Like it's like a thing, like you only need 2-3 hours
of sleep. It was like a genetic thing.
And guess what, you guys? She was so much smarter than all of us, because she, okay, let me make something clear. If I only needed 2 hours of sleep a night, especially in college, I would just be partying till the dawn. And then if I wasn't partying, I would just be watching reality TV and be eating Cheetos in my bed and taking more baths. I'd be like, oh great, more hours for more times to warm up my cold bones.
Yeah.
But this
the
woman-
only difference you see with 15 more hours a week is just the water bill's higher. It's costing you more to be awake longer.
But this person, she would like take the time to read and study more, and it was like incredible.
Yeah, there's no way. I feel like the same thing. I would absolutely
I would use it for good.
Just be like, yeah, I saw 3 more movies than I would have before.
I feel like I got through the Oscar list.
Yeah,
so,
I scrolled, ran longer. I watched more movies. Ate more food.
Speaking of watching more movies, guess what, everyone? Guess what I saw? Now, I didn't watch the Oscars or the red carpet, so I don't know like exactly how it went. But our king, Jesse Palmer, was one of the hosts on the red carpet at the Oscars.
Wow.
He's moving up.
JP is moving on up. Like, wow. I mean, that's a prestigious
position.
Are
the Oscars on ABC? Like, is it the same network?
Mm.
Oh, maybe. That's what I was thinking. But
cross promotion.
Are you just discounting his efforts and work towards the Academy community? Like, what are you?
I would never do that. Yeah, Jesse's going to. So is he going to move on? Is he going to move up and on? Is he going to leave us behind?
I'm kind of feeling like this weird feeling in my bones.
That he's out.
That like, he's not going to be out soon, but in 2 years. I feel like Jesse's going to leave us in the dust.
See, I don't think he'll ever leave because it's too easy of a gig. When you actually think about it, like we said, we see him, he goes, and here is a thing. And then he leaves.
But
you know?
He is so gone.
He's
kind of
like, why would I ever say bye? You know what I mean? Like, he's like, why would I ever say bye to this thing?
But he's gone. He's gone for like, you know, a few months at a time. In fact, he was posting. I did, of course, look at his Instagram after the Oscars because I was like, I felt so much joy and pride. And I was like, that's my Bigfoot daddy out there on the red carpet doing his thing, like talking to the stars. But he was also then posting photos of Tulum, which is where they did the fantasy suites. And he was like, I was in Tulum too, essentially, and posting snapshots of basically just him dining
in
the
pool.
Like, he was just chilling because we haven't seen him at all.
All he was doing was writing letters to the couple saying, you guys can go to bed together.
He's just in his hotel room with a quill.
They're like, don't forget the letters. He's like, oh yeah, I forgot about that. He's like, why haven't we gotten producers just to do these? They're like, it's tradition.
You know, I feel like as much as Jesse, we give him a hard time.
They want to take away from him, and he's adamant on doing it.
Listen, a man
he's
who
like,
could
the way
make
I ride it is different.
A man who could make his way from being the Bachelor into like all of his sports, into like these cooking shows, into being the host of the show, and now hosting the red carpet. I think this man goes above and beyond. In fact, part of me, I could see him as the type of guy who would like take calligraphy classes to write them gorgeous letters for the fantasy suites. Like, he's taking this very seriously. I feel that.
I feel like he's such a. We give him a hard time, but I honestly do feel like he's probably an extremely hardworking, extremely vigilant person. And I just want to say, I'm really sorry for ever saying anything, Jesse, that you don't really have a job or that you don't work or that you just go on vacation and say three words. That's wrong of me.
It is wrong of you. I don't know if you saw him.
It has more to do with jealousy than anything. And I think that's something that says a lot more about me than it does about you.
It 100% does. You need to apologize to him because I don't know if you saw him on those avocado posters in the grocery store. Okay, don't dismiss our avocado king.
is he like a spokesman for avocados now?
I think so. We talked about it a little bit. People had taken photos of him. He was like part of Big Avocado, and he's like on all these posters in the grocery store. It's just something to think about. He's everywhere.
He's everywhere.
He's in the sports world. He's in the reality TV world.
He's got a good agent.
He's in the grocery world. He's now on the red carpets, which is like the serious acting world.
Yeah.
I mean, he was in the baking world. He was involving himself in that during the holidays. I mean, I don't know, you guys. Maybe a new theory.
He's like the new Shaq.
He's infiltrating.
You know, Shaq, just for the longest time, would like sell everything. It was just like he was the face of every product.
And Shaq is like so wealthy. I think Jesse Palmer is like going to be absolutely, in a few years, Jesse Palmer will be so loaded and he will be everywhere.
Well,
like he'll be, I'm just saying, he's everywhere. It's just something to process. Anyway.
Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Hope you all are sleeping. Sorry if I'm saying some Delulu things. I am just oh so tired.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm complaining into the void because we all went through it. So I'm not special.
It's also one of those things too, where like back when we were young before iPhones, like it was a thing, right? You always set your clocks back, set your clocks forward. It was like people, oh, I forgot to do it. I'm late for work. Now the phones just do it. So you just wake up shittier and you're like, why am I in a grumpy mood? So I feel like it's almost like it takes like a week to kind of recover.
That's true. Yeah, that's true.
So to everyone in the world, does everyone? Yeah, everyone does it, right? Is that a world
not
thing?
Everyone.
Not everyone. I don't think.
I feel like Arizona doesn't do
it. Yeah.
See, that's now we're starting to get into some weird like. No, is people this a conspiracy.
Like, well, it's like there's like voting on it about like people are trying.
How can you vote on the time?
No, because we're gonna be setting. It's all about setting our clock back.
No, I know.
Stuff.
I'm just saying. At some point, it's like voting on the moon. Like, what are we? What are we talking about? How is this even a thing? How can some people do it? Some people not do it. How could it be voted on?
Yeah.
Like, how was it even? You know what I'm saying? I need to do some research because this is blowing my mind. That'd be like, voting on the nighttime. Who here votes no more nighttime exists? And they're like, hear ye, and then the nighttime's gone. Like, what the hell's going on? How can you just vote on time?
Because we're deciding on if we're going to push if we're just going to have it be dark later or like brighter earlier. Like, so then they rearrange it. Please research. It's blowing my mind that you didn't know about this.
How can you vote on time?
But that's probably what happened in the first place. It's why we're here. People are probably voted on the clock moving forward.
Wait, so hold on. So you're telling telling me if Arizona doesn't do it and they're an hour ahead of us, we're just on the same time as them for a chunk of the year?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
So, like, you know what I'm saying? So, like, you know how you go, because there's Eastern time, Mountain time, right?
Yeah.
So, all of a sudden, we're just, like, in the East Coast, and then we're just back?
Yeah.
Maybe I'm talking out of my ass. I sound so ridiculous right now, but no, I feel confident. So,
like, if you have a business partner in Arizona, and you have a Zoom call every Monday, and all of a sudden, your clock goes ahead, and you're like, actually, same time.
Yeah.
I guess so.
No, I'm pretty sure.
But hopefully, the vote passes, where we can just delete time.
No more time.
Okay, someone send me some DMs about what's going on here, because this is blowing my mind. How can you vote on time?
The idea of what time is and dimensions don't blow up in his mind, but the idea of voting on
time. We're having a vote this year on space. Do we allow it to be there or not? Please come down to the city hall. If it passes, we will get rid of space. The moon is up next.
Let's just get rid of the sun. Yeah, that thing is too hot.
The sun is too hot. Who wants to reduce the heat of the sun? Arizona, for the fifth time, is saying they want to reduce it. Seattle is fine. What are we going to do here? The sun is too hot. A click, 5 degrees. A reduction in 5 degrees, effective immediately. Someone tell the sun.
Okay, we have to take a quick pause. The time is blowing your mind. We have to take a quick pause before we get into this. Family, speaking of fantasy suites, okay? Speaking of fantasy suites, not time. Speaking of fantasy suites, once upon a time, I downloaded an app that makes it look like my phone is a bottle of champagne. And, you know, you get to, like, pour it out, you know, that thing. You know what I'm talking about.
I do remember
that.
Well,
turns out, after using that once as a gag on someone, I forgot I had it, and I continued to pay for it monthly, which I did not need. And this happens more frequently than I would like to admit, which is why Rocket Money has been the game changer for me. Did you know nearly 75% of people have subscriptions they've forgotten about? Between streaming services, fitness apps, and delivery services, it's never ending. Thanks to Rocket Money, I am no longer wasting money on the ones I forget about. We love Rocket Money so much.
It's the best. We're so grateful for Rocket Money. Rocket Money is a personal finance app that finds and cancels your unwanted subscriptions, monitors your spending, and helps lower your bills so that you can grow your savings. With Rocket Money, we have full control over our subscriptions and a clear view of our expenses. We can see all our subscriptions in one place, and if we see something we don't want, Rocket Money can cancel it for us with a few taps. I love how the dashboard shows me this month's spending compared to last month, so I can clearly see my spending habits too. Plus, they'll help me create a custom budget, which is huge in keeping my spending on track.
Yeah, it's really amazing. Rocket Money will even try to negotiate to lower your bills for you by up to 20%. It's incredible. All you have to do is submit a picture of your bill and Rocket Money takes care of the rest. They'll deal with the customer service for you even. Oh my gosh, what a gift. Rocket Money has over 5 million users and has saved a total of 500 million in canceled subscriptions, okay? Saving members up to $740 a year when using all of the app's features. We absolutely love it. Stop wasting money on things you don't use. Cancel your unwanted subscriptions by going to rocketmoney.com/momdad. That's rocketmoney.com/momdad. rocketmoney.com/momdad. Okay, well, I know you're probably stuck on time, but
diving into this later. I can barely think about what we're about to talk about because all I can think about is the time.
Actually, speaking of time, kind of. Let's talk schedule for one sec here, okay? So everybody, if you're watching this on Wednesday, I believe tonight the Love is Blind reunion airs at 9 p.m. Eastern Pacific. I'm not sure. I have to check. But the reunion airs.
Yeah.
I am literally on the edge of my seat. The previews for it look bananas. It looks like
there's so much like tension and
it
stuff.
It also looks like everyone, for the most part, is showing up and like they're going to be addressing all of the drama. So I can't wait. I'm so excited. Here's the plan. The plan is that we will be dropping our recap and thoughts of the Love is Blind reunion on Monday. So Monday, March 18th. So that is the plan next week, Monday, March 18th, that we will drop the recap of the Love is Blind reunion. And then, of course, we have then on Wednesday, our Bachelor recap, which we're going to be covering the Women Tell All. Which I am also, it's going to be like reunion Women Tell All energy next week. I'm excited. It's going to be dramatic. I can't wait. I can't wait.
So. If Maria and what's her name?
Sydney
made up, break it off. Because I want some actual, I want you guys to tear into each other.
Think about
I
this,
want
though.
Chaos.
But there's potential for that because we're also, it's not just Maria and Sydney. There's also Jess.
There's also
Leia.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. There's numerous potentials for drama to be had.
Are they
going to
announce
people.
The Bachelorette?
I don't think so.
Sometimes they do and sometimes they don't. Or is
I
that...
think they'll probably wait until the
they gotta
finale.
Wait, right? The finale.
Yeah.
Right. But so then it'll be a couple
because
weeks.
Because the Bachelorette might be one of like the second choice. Like,
oh, sure.
You know?
Sure. Okay. You know what I noticed you do a really good job of?
What?
You look into the camera kind of regularly. And I was noticing this because I was watching one of our episodes and I was like, you look into the camera and I never do. And
do you feel uncomfortable making eye contact with our beloved family?
I kind of do a little bit. Not uncomfortable, but it's something like I'll look kind of next to it or at you or at Lee or down at a monitor.
Yeah.
But like just to go like... Like, does that weird you out, people? When I'm looking right at you right now? Like, you know what I mean? It's like if you've had a dad that's sure. like, and always struggled with eye contact and all of a sudden one day he looks at you. Is this too intimate now? I don't know. I feel like I'm looking into you. Like, it's a little, you know, I feel like you do. It's so natural. I notice when we're talking, you'll kind of look. And then I realized, oh, you're looking at the camera, looking at them. And I'm like, wow, what a good connection. I've been over here just not avoiding eye contact.
I really appreciate you complimenting. You know, they do call me the Jim Halpert of your mom and dad.
Oh, my. I was like, wait, because did he have good eye contact? No, it's because you're always breaking the third wall or whatever that is. this feels very Joey. Just
staring into the camera. Not
just
blinking.
Staring at you, never blinking. This is how I do the podcast. Be like, you know, I was really thinking a lot about the fact that the new Bachelorette might be announced. So, anyway, just something I noticed and something I wanted to bring it up.
I appreciate that compliment. Thanks. You know, I do. I think it's aligned more with me and I do like looking into the camera and really like, you know, making sure that, you know, we're all seeing each other.
I love that.
Also, I do really think that if I would be on a reality TV show, it would be extremely difficult for me not to look directly into the camera.
So like they're always like, Jessica, stop.
I'm no model. If you put a camera in front of me and start trying to take photos, I don't know what to do, but I will stare directly into it. Like that's just my eyes will go.
It's funny, I do forget the cameras are here. I know it sounds really corny, but like I'm so good at that. It's crazy. I don't mean that in a braggy way, man. I'm just saying, man, that like I kind of, I think because I avoid them, I forget they're there.
Yeah,
but well, I do I love the idea idea of like a rose ceremony and you're just and they keep having to like cut you out of scenes because you just stare at the camera.
They'd have to kick me off night one because it would just be like, this is too much of a problem. I'd just be staring into it
constantly.
It's
funny. There has been through the seasons, like I've noticed people look at the camera, like not a lot, but like I've noticed an occasional contestant just kind of look like in the corner.
Do you remember who it was?
No, I don't even remember.
Because that's my soul sister.
But every once in a while, I'll just like clock like, oh, they didn't notice that she kind of looked or they just left it in. And I'm very aware of like, whoa. Like, that's weird. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean? Like, we're always eavesdropping on their life. But when they look at you, you're like, oh.
Yeah.
There are cameras there. I forgot about that.
I don't know. There's something that I love about, like, talking, and then quick breaking to the camera. And it's like, oh, I'm having a moment with my people. It's like, oh, we're connecting for a second. Like, we're having a joke together.
It is funny how, like, on The Bachelorette or any reality show, that they'll do this thing where they're living their lives with everyone. And then there's ITMs. So the ITMs, they're looking directly at us, talking to us.
Yeah.
But then it flashes to like the normal show and they won't dare look in the camera. Mm-hmm. But I'd love to see where like they're regularly interacting with the camera.
It'd
be like,
for sure.
Like fighting with someone and then just look at the camera and be like, am I insane? Or like,
I would
look,
love
you know
that.
What I mean? And she's looking right at like, she's insane.
Yeah.
That would be a move.
That would be good.
Another beautiful idea from us. All right, let's get into this.
Let's talk
Sorry, I'm on one today. My bad.
Let's get into the fantasy suite, shall we?
Yeah.
Anywho, that's our schedule for next week. Fantasy suite time. Suite time. They are in Tulum, Mexico, people.
The influencer capital of the world.
Yes, secrets, baby. And guess what? We don't have something that I felt like is a detrimental, not detrimental, that's probably the wrong word, an integral, essential thing in this process. That's the word I was looking for. Essential piece to this process is that there was no moment where Joey got to have his like sit down with someone who tells him about sex. You know what I mean?
Like there was and the bees
no,
talk?
Yeah, there was no birds and bees talk. You know, we had it.
Because last year we had Gary talking to Jesse.
Yeah, I was saying, even the older gentleman had the birds and bees talk where he sat down with Jesse. I mean, before that, Jesse sat down with Zach, and Zach was like, "Sex week."
Jesse's like, "You gonna fuck?" Gary's like, "Listen, absolutely. I absolutely will."
Stop.
He's like, don't be so silly. Absolutely, I will. Been waiting for this moment for a very long time.
Yeah, you're right. No one kind of had a big brother talk.
No, there wasn't even like a dial in from a Sean Lowe, like a bachelor of yore to come in. I guess they just trust that Joey knows what he's doing because everyone else they apparently don't trust. Like, we got to sit you down and let you know what this whole thing is. Yes, Zach, it's sex week. Just let Joey go off on his own.
Jesse didn't even get like another like kind of tennis lesson to talk about it. You think they would have done something like that?
That's what I'm saying. I was imagining there was going to be a back and forth. Yes, there was going to be on the golf course or on the tennis court, some sort of, hey, so you know what this week means,
right?
And what does that mean for you? They just had an interview with Joey where Joey all of a sudden
just breaks down,
full crying, and is like, listen, I one time in my life completely let go in this love space and then it got ripped away. And it's charity, which I was like, I didn't know. Maybe did we miss this? But I felt like during charity season when they would talk about Joey, like, you know, we'd see like a fear here and there, but I don't feel like we ever heard the narrative, at least what we were seeming to get from a lot of these ITMs from Joey this episode, that charity was like his first love type energy.
That's what he said.
Didn't he say that? I was like,
he basically said that Charity was the only woman like he ever loved.
Yeah. And I was like, why didn't we talk about this on the season? That feels like a huge piece that was missing on charity season, that Joey's like, this is the first person I've ever truly loved.
I think it's no one would have believed him.
Really?
Well, because he's like a smoking hot tennis instructor who lives in Hawaii.
I mean, I get it.
Or maybe he was just saying he loved her the most. I don't know, but he definitely made it sound like, oh, she was the one and only.
Yeah, I'm just saying, I would think that would have been like a big storyline during charity season. Maybe he didn't ever really share that or talk about it. Maybe
it's a version of the virgin storyline. You know how they're like, oh, this person, like the one person on this is a virgin. His could be like the I've never loved
someone. Yeah. But I would think that they would have talked about it. Maybe he kept it really close to his chest, which isn't a bad move. It's probably a smart move to be like, hey, I'm not going to share all of these things. And now all of a sudden we're maybe hearing this for the first time, that Charity was like the one woman he's ever loved, which is actually
gotta feel good. Charity, just like in your life, knowing like the one.
I mean, Charity, that always feels good. Charity, remember Charity season, how they were all in love with her. Remember that? It was literally like Charity walked in and everyone was like jaw on the floor, heart in the sky. Like everyone was in love with her.
Yes.
But with this situation, then I'm kind of now watching it going, Joey was like really struggling to the point that I'm like, is he ready to have moved on?
It
feels still like a pretty open wound. Like, it feels still like it was really, I know grief, it can come in waves, but like, it felt like it was still a very present, like, pain for him.
Yeah. I wasn't ready for him to be at the end like this with three amazing women who seem to be very into him. And his main focus is that, like, am I still into Charity, or not even into Charity, but like hurt by that whole thing and, you know, still messed up by the process. I was a little bit like, it's been a while. She's like lived her life. But
really, I guess timing wise, though, he didn't get that much time. No, I think he got a couple months.
Oh, okay. That's true.
He got thrown into it. I mean, if you were in love with somebody, like that's huge.
It's funny. I just sometimes forget that some people
actually fall in love. Well,
not that they don't fall in love, but like they fall in like, you know what I mean? Like through this process, you can fall into a big like with someone.
You don't think you can fall in love?
I think you can, but I also think that like it's not that
skeptic
today. No. It's not that they can't fall in love. It's that as a viewer, sometimes you just kind of can go, well, there's no way they can actually fall that deeply in love because it was only like this little amount of time. And I forget that like when you're like in this very concentrated environment, you can lose yourself.
Also,
there are
plenty of people in this world who met and got married within like 2 weeks.
You're right. They meet on vacation and they get married a week later.
I know I had to grind you down for like 7 years before you were lost. Some people fall in love.
Do you know what? Let's move on.
Some people fall in love in minutes.
We're still working on me getting there. No, but it's just like
I still have fingers crossed that Evan's fallen in love with me at this point.
I'm tripping. I'm like Kelsey. I'm tripping in love. Soon to be falling. Soon to be in.
But honestly, that was wild to me. And that was kind of rattled me in a way that I was like, oh, this was not what I saw coming.
Yeah.
I knew he had I could tell that he had deep feelings for Charity. At least it seemed that way as a viewer.
Yeah.
But not that it was like, this is the one time.
He's still messed up.
Yeah. And this was the one time that I gave my full heart and soul and the one woman I've loved. And I am like absolutely destroyed. And if that is true, the process would destroy you.
Yeah.
If this was like the first time I've ever been in love was on The Bachelor and then on The Bachelorette and I'm proposing and then it's not me. And he said later in the episode, he's like, I knew it was me. So he was like convinced that Charity was going to accept his proposal.
And then
so,
if he knew it was him, then he's going, these girls could feel the same way, or I could feel the same way about these girls, and then have them be like, no, I'm not into you.
Exactly. So that kind of made me go, okay, I get the paranoia that he's feeling a little more now in the sense of like, what if someone doesn't choose me in the end?
Yeah.
If his first process of falling in love was really on this show.
It's interesting. This has kind of been my personal feeling about Joey this whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Is I'm not seeing Joey madly fall in love with anyone.
He's
falling
in love with the process.
I see him really wanting to be loved. Does that make sense?
Yeah, no, I hear that.
Like his concern is so much more about will they leave me?
Yeah.
And far less about am I going to find the one?
Yeah.
So it almost just seems like as long as he leaves with one of the three, it's almost like he'll be happy. I'm not saying this is the case, but I'm saying that's the energy I'm getting. It's like not a lot of talk about like, I'm really struggling because they're both amazing and I'm trying to figure out like at the end, they're always generally talking about, I can't choose. I'm obsessed with both and they both are so different. Da, da. But right now it's like, I really hope they don't leave.
Yeah.
Which
no,
is like a very different.
He deeply wants to be loved.
And generally you also kind of see the lead being like, really into one person,
mm-hmm.
where he's kind of equally into all three almost in a way. I mean, there's some differences we'll talk about.
I definitely feel like there's
differences,
there's
but generally you see it a lot more, it feels like.
Yes.
Where you're like,
no,
this
I
is
agree.
Done
you're
unless
right,
they
you're
shock
right,
us.
You're right.
I don't know, interesting.
No, that is actually very interesting to think about. That does definitely seem to be his energy. He seems to deeply want to be like really loved by someone, which makes me feel worried for him via the previews and also via this note that Kelsey left ultimately that I kind of have a theory. Okay, I'm going to say this before we take another quick pause. I have this theory. And this is my theory, okay? Because I felt really good about the fact that I called last episode what happened this episode.
Okay.
Last episode, I said, I think that Leslie's going to talk to Kelsey. It's going to rattle Kelsey. And then that Kelsey's going to go on the date.
Yeah.
And then I said, I think I said she talks to her after the date. I might have mixed that up. But then I said, I bet Kelsey's the one writing the letter. And I was
right.
And I was right. I feel really good about it.
You did.
I felt really good about that. So this is my new theory, okay? My continued theory is that Kelsey is going to talk to Joey and she's going to be like, I am really, really concerned about, you know, getting my heart broken. I don't think I, if it's not me, I want you to let me go. And he's going to be like, I think it's you. And so I think she's going to stay. And then it's going to be her and someone else. Okay. I'm assuming it's going to be Daisy just off of the energy that I've been seeing, but we'll see.
Well, and is what he said, but yeah.
Yeah. And also what are the words he used, but I'm picturing then Kelsey and Daisy being at the end. And I think what's going to happen is that he might, or maybe even this. Okay. I take this back. Hold on. So I,
this theory has been really fleshed out.
First of all, she didn't have a theory. She came up with it right now.
No, I'm not that. I
have this theory that just is coming up to me right now.
Okay, no, what I'm saying is this. I think that he's going to then say, Kelsey, yes, it is you.
Yeah.
And I, you know, I still have to keep going on along with this process, but I'm pretty sure it's you. You need to stay. Yeah. And then I think he might let Daisy go and be like, I don't think it's happening. I think I see it with someone else. And he might let her go early. And then Kelsey doesn't show up to the altar.
Okay, so it's a double
burn.
And
he's got one left. With one left, Kelsey is like, you know what? I'm still not sure.
Yeah.
Because maybe she didn't know that he had that conversation with Daisy because they're separate. And so he's like, oh, I'm going to let Daisy go home first. So that, like, you know, I just have this. But Kelsey doesn't know that Daisy's gone home. So then Kelsey doesn't show up to the rose ceremony. Or sorry, to the ring ceremony.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good.
That is good.
Yeah. And that would lead him. That would be a first. Yeah. And that would also lead him to him like sobbing.
Well, you are the guesser of all like crime documentaries. And so I think it is true. She'll be like within the 3 minutes. She's like, he did this and did this and did this.
When we watch suspenseful crime documentary, because I don't want to ruin it for Evan, within 5 minutes, I open my notes app. I write down what I believe is the ending. And then I show him at the end and I go, look, I was right. Most of the time I'm right.
He was laughing at like, he doesn't want to ruin it for me. And I'm just like, in the corner going, yay! Believing, no, he didn't. Believing every hook in the line. All right.
Okay, let's take another pause and then we'll get into the actual dates, okay? But important theory conversation. Family. So, again, it's a fantasy suite week. Yeah. And in the words of Zach, anyway, we don't even have to go there. Speaking of this, it's no secret that for some individuals, consuming a little THC can help them set the mood. However, getting that right strain and dosage can be difficult. That's why we're thankful for today's sponsor, Vaya. Vaya has developed a unique blend of pleasure-enhancing cannabinoids, libido-strengthening herbs, and a low dose of THC all into one mind-blowing gummy called High Love. We're talking about pairing aphrodisiac herbs with a mild amount of THC. Their best-selling High Love gummy will awaken your senses, increase blood flow, and intensify any sexual experience. And I shared this last time, but I will just say that Evan and I have tried High Love, and we absolutely enjoy it. Okay, we'll leave it at that. So if you're interested, and if you're 21 plus, check out the link to Vaya in our description and use code MOMDAD to get 15% off.
Vaya also offers a wide array of other gummies with and without THC, which I think is amazing. Mm-hmm. Each with their own unique strengths and effects catered for your routines. I really enjoyed all the different gummies I have tried personally. There's this one called Dreams that I took the other night before bed. I slept incredible.
Yeah.
Their products have great flavor and are made with vegan and organic ingredients. Their products range from 2 milligrams to 50 milligrams of THC. So these guys have you covered, whether you're looking for the little microdose vibes or enjoy more potent effects.
By the way, they also have zero THC products that I love. If THC isn't for you, you can still take advantage of their CBD line with products designed for sleep, focus, and energy. My personal faves are Flow State when I'm working and Zen before bedtime. They're amazing. Let the gummies work their magic. Head to viahemp.com and use the code MOMDAD to receive 15% off plus one free sample of their Sleepy Dreams gummy. This is 21 plus. The reminder, this is 21 plus. That's VIIAHEMP viahemp.com and use code MOMDAD at checkout. Take your passion and pleasure to a whole new level with High Love from Via Hemp. All right, let's talk about the first lovely lady that we see, and that is Rachel. Mm-hmm. And before Rachel goes on her official one-on-one fantasy suite date with Joey, Rachel gets the first sit down. We have the golden ladies coming out to give advice, and Rachel gets to sit down with Susan. Which I would be like, oh, so jealous. Obviously.
They always like zoom out and you just see her hair going like this while she's talking.
I love Susan so much.
I always just wonder what people like that, like, they're just born with just like an extra injection of just endorphin energy.
You just like Susan's positive
just the
vibes.
Way that she comes in, she's like, hi, and she's like, bam, and I'm like, man, like
the presence.
No,
what
truly
I would do
the presence
for just 20% of that. I mean, she's gotta be buzzing.
She really
she's
is.
Gotta feel amazing. Anyway,
and she came in she was great. She was such like a, she right away said, she's like, think of me as your mom and your best friend right now. She's like, I just have a free trip to Tulum. So you got me
she's
for
like,
1 hour.
I am back at the pool.
You got me for 1 hour. Yeah. I have a massage schedule at 11 a.m.
Yes.
So, you know, I'm your mom and best friend till 11.
Yes.
Till the clock strikes 11.
I have a happy hour. I have a dance. I have a club.
We've got it all packed in there. And Rachel then opens up and talks about how her exes were critical of her goofy side. She talks about how we find out what the pain was that her parents were talking about.
Yeah.
That Rachel's past two like long-term relationships both cheated on her.
Brutal.
Which is so gnarly. And you mentioned when we were watching this, you're like, damn, this show would be really, really hard to go on as a contestant if you had been cheated on, especially like twice in a row, just because
wild
of that constant feeling of like, you know, this isn't a one-on-one relationship energy. It would be
right.
Really tough.
It would be super tough. I was kind of shocked by the, like, when you saw how broken she was about it, when you saw her family and how broken they were about it. Definitely like, remember when she said to her dad, you know me, dad, I'm kind of wild. I was like,
yeah,
and now I get it.
Yeah, she'd choose a risk taker.
Because if I was dad, I'd be like, what in the world are you doing? Like,
yeah,
you just got cheated on twice. Now you're going on a show where he's going to be openly sleeping with other women. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Will that mess with your head? So that kind of, I feel like that led me to understand her a little bit more. Like, she's a little bit more of a risk. She's a little more wild and crazy than she kind of lets on. Because she lets on as being very, like, she even says, like, walls closed a little bit more calculated, a little bit more, like, not really letting you in. But now I feel like you're kind of seeing, like, oh, maybe, you know.
We definitely got to know her more in this conversation. That's
agreed.
For sure. And, you know, she did say that it's like, yeah, now I'm having this feeling, like, as I'm processing through this, that it's like, oh, now I'm, there's a trigger of, like, a man picking, she's like, oh, feeling like he's picking another woman over me and all of that trauma coming back. And, you know, I felt like, she did tell Susan, she's like, I am in love. I am in love, though.
Yeah.
And I have got my walls up because of my past and what's gone on, but I am in love. And Susan, I feel like Susan gives great advice. You know, she was like, it's okay to be in love. She's like, you need to remember that you, she's like, girl, what this show taught me is that I am the prize and that I have to love myself before I love anyone else. I was like, okay, RuPaul.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I don't know. I felt like Susan came in and really gave a good pep talk, letting Rachel know you need to be vulnerable in love. It's going to be okay. And if you walk out of this heartbroken, you know, look at me. I didn't end up with Gary, but now look at what Susan's doing. Mm-hmm. Like, she's made all these amazing friends. She's traveling all over the world. She has all these amazing opportunities. And I'm sure she's, you know, her world has opened up to meeting all sorts of new people. So I felt like Susan was a great partner for Rachel to have in this process. And we saw it because right away, well, I shouldn't say right away. There was an incident before, but later in Rachel's time with Joey, Rachel really let the walls down.
Yeah.
I mean, she started sobbing. She put it all out there for him. And she took a big leap of faith by, like, you know, kind of in the final hour, letting him know, hey, I don't know if I'm too far behind right now. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you're farther along with the other two and if I'm coming in too late. But essentially, even if I am, I'm going to show you myself because I am like falling in love with you.
Mm-hmm.
So here's me. And I don't know. I thought it was really beautiful.
I thought so, too.
Now, when we see the dates in comparison to what Joey said, at least what we were shown, maybe it's editing and they're trying to mess with us.
Sure.
But we saw Joey say certain things to Kelsey, which we'll talk about, and certain things to Daisy, which we didn't see him say to Rachel, which obviously leads all of us to believe that Rachel is probably the one that he will be sending home unless Kelsey leaves early. So that definitely made me feel nervous for Rachel that I'm like, damn, it just looked like, I don't know, maybe I'm putting the cart before the horse and he might end up choosing Rachel, but yeah. I was just like, damn, it's like she really put herself all out there and she's really been through a shit ton. And but she's such she, like, a she said beautiful little too late. Person. I know.
Like too little too late. I think there's a little bit of that going on.
No, I think so too.
I think that she, you know, even if she didn't say I love you early enough or whatever.
Yeah.
Like Kelsey didn't either. But I think that Kelsey kind of threw herself into the process maybe a little bit more.
Yeah. And was just I think she was putting out more like feelers quick by being like, I'm tripping. Like exactly. letting him know like, hey, I'm getting
it's
there.
It's happening. And then also just really surrendering herself to like being completely open and probably crying in front of him all the time about mom and all these different things. So it was very like comparatively, you know?
Yeah.
And so when you get to that end, those things start to shrink and become more and more important. Yeah.
But if he doesn't choose Rachel yeah. just bums you out because she's so cool and lovely and seems like a pretty amazing person. Yeah. And he says that he has like this special, that he has so much fun with her and he's got this great connection. And I just hope that she doesn't feel too hurt if he doesn't choose her because of her then putting all of herself out there. But again, like I said, they could be totally fucking with us in editing. And maybe he totally told her that he was also falling in love and they cut it out to like, try to like mess like, with us.
Yeah, that's true.
So, you know, there's still the chance.
That's true.
But that's the feel we got. Yeah. But in between all of this, they have their day date portion and they decide, Joey lets her know, he's like, hey, can you hold your breath underwater for a long time? And do you like wild animals?
Yeah.
And she's like, yes. And so he shows up and takes her to a cenote where they're going to be jumping in the water, which is stunning, beautiful.
Amazing.
But I'll be real with you.
I'm so jealous.
She then goes, what are we doing with wild animals? And he goes, oh, I was just messing with you. I would have been pissed.
Yeah, like that's the only thing I cared about.
I would have been like, you led with like, do I like wild animals? Yes, I do. Yeah. And then all of a sudden you just go, just kidding. We're just jumping in water. Like, you're like, you're teasing me with the idea that I might be scuba diving coming face to face with glorious creatures, like, or I don't know, engaging with who knows what in the animal kingdom, and you just then go, it was a joke. I'd never let him live it down. I'd be furious.
But I did love this date. Right. Yeah, that's exactly. I'm pissed. Like,
that's it.
But I did love this date. This was very.
I know
mean.
You were so into.
It's
this
like
date.
This gorgeous cenote, and they have these like different levels you can jump off into the water. It's very, you know, very fun. But then the second I said I would love this date. Okay. She jumps off the like second or third level.
No, the top level. So there's different levels that you can jump into and it's like, ooh, we're doing it. Obviously me as not an athletic adventure risk taker, I'm going, is there champagne at the top level?
Right.
Like I'm not jumping off the top level.
Where's the lounge?
Like, who's going to go before me? Are you sending a producer to jump off before me?
Right.
Like, is there going to be, no, that's way too high. But they're like, no, Rachel, do it. She jumps off fully, like fucks up her jaw jumping into the water.
Yeah, I think she kind of did one of these where it's like maybe you're trying
forward.
Not to, you know, you kind of have to jump backwards a little bit so that you correct. And I think she jumped and kind of went like face planted.
No. And she comes up and immediately, and Rachel is like, you know, I feel like you don't see Rachel sweat.
No, she's real tough.
And like she also, you know, she hasn't been other than outside of her hometown after meeting the family. That was really the first time we saw her crying. So like when Sheik popped up and Joey was like, wasn't that awesome? Just funny. He's like, wasn't that amazing? And she's like, ow, 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 ow. And he's like, oh, did you hurt yourself? She's like, yeah, it hurts. It hurts. And he's like, are you going to be good? And she's like, no, it hurts so bad.
Yeah.
And so then they end up taking her out. I mean, it gets to the point, Lee. So we have the medic come out, check on her. She can't even barely talk to him. She can't open her jaw. And she's like trying so hard to be like, yeah. So, sorry about all this. But like, you can tell is in so much pain. Every once in a while, she's wiping.
I'm falling she's wiping, for you.
she's every once in a while wiping tears away where you're like, oh my God, she can't move her jaw. So you're like not seeing her cry, but tears are coming out. She's in so much pain. The medic comes to see her and is like, yeah, I don't know. They have to take her to the ER.
Oh no.
Like that's what their date becomes is they take her to the local ER.
And then they have to wire her mouth shut and then she's like, oh, I'm here. And he's like, I can't hear you.
That is not part of what happened.
I'm falling for you. And he's like, oh man, I just wish that we could have connected more.
And through all this, Joey's going, wow, it's crazy because she's really opening up to me. I was like, you know when you're in so much pain and you're like so traumatized you can't help but I'm like, yeah, she's opening up to you because she's literally in like searing pain. Like she has no other option.
I'm in so much pain. He's like, thank you for telling me that. It's just like, that means a lot. She's like, more medication. He's like, thank you for telling me.
I was like, yeah, because she didn't have an option. But they literally ended up then having to take her to the ER.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was literally losing it because they had Joey explaining what happened. And I'm like, I know that they had a producer before, but the fact that I'm like, can we not get her? Like, if I was, this is what I'm imagining. If I'm Rachel, I'm blood red mad because all I can imagine is them walking into the hospital and being like, Joey, can you stand there and can we do that shot one more time?
Right.
Can you
like explain? Roll her back.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Take the blood again, please.
Yeah, can you explain to the doctor exactly what happened again? And Rachel's just like in horrible pain. Like, why are the cameras with me right now? Can you just catch up with me later?
Yeah.
That's all I could imagine.
See, I took this whole thing differently.
Okay.
I think she was good at the cenote. I think producers jumped on it as like, we have an arc we can throw on here.
She didn't seem good at the hospital. No.
I'm saying this. I bet she was like, I think I'm good. Or like, it hurts, but I'll be okay.
After the medic checked her.
Yes. Like, it hurts, but I'll be okay. I think the producers then go, we should do a hospital visit.
Oh, and they want to make it more dramatic. Okay.
Then she was tweaked about my whole day's ruined.
Yeah.
Now I can't go on the date. Now we cannot connect. Now we're like in a hospital. It's so cold and awkward and whatever.
Oh, okay.
Because the room's like perfectly lit. Like to me, it was like they jumped on this as an opportunity.
Sure. Yeah.
Perhaps. I didn't feel like she was pushing for the hospital. I feel like they looked at Joey and go, okay, we're going to go to the hospital. This is a perfect like opportunity. Joey, make sure you say, we got to go to the hospital. And they said, we got to go to the hospital. And then they're there. And then she's bummed about the whole thing going to shit. That was the energy I took.
Okay.
Because then they get there and she's like, we took x-rays, everything's fine. And she's like, thanks. And then they're good and they left. And she's like, my jaw's fine now. Like, I think that she was feeling like, yeah, it got zinged, but I'm okay. I'm not like broken or something.
Right. Well, I mean, she was really struggling at first, though.
No. I'm like, at first. I'm saying about over time.
Over like the hours.
Over like
30
minutes, they were like, okay, she's starting to feel good. But they're like, they're already made the decision. We're headed there and doing this whole thing. That was kind of like, maybe. I thought about it more and I thought, I don't know.
Well, Rachel, let us know how you were feeling, because I mean, that just, but I just was devastated for her, because there's nothing, there's literally nothing worse too than like just the feeling like the idea of being on a date and then getting hurt and then it being that whole thing is just like, oh man, it's just, it makes you feel, and you shouldn't feel this way, but like, you know, as a human, you're like, yeah, I feel awkward now and whatever, but then adding the cameras on top of it too. And it's like, there's cameras in my face and I'm just like, I was really hoping for this really romantic final before fantasy suite date. And now I'm trying to like keep it together, but I am in so much pain and now I'm at the hospital and then they probably separate them because, you know, when they reunited at night, he was like, oh, so you're better. And she's like, yeah. And she's like moving her jaw around. She's like, I'm good, you know, whatever. So then they had many hours apart too. Who knows how long, but it's like, damn, I could have had this whole thing. And if, you know, if we would have been on a boat like Kelsey A later too, we would have had like the boat ride in, snorkeling, the boat ride back out. We had the hospital, like, oh man,
brutal.
It was so brutal. It was so brutal. But again, they then ended up having the night portion. She really ended up then opening up to him. And then we did get the card from Jesse, the offer of the fantasy suite. And they took it. And with the two of them, the next morning when they woke up, you and I both agreed, it definitely seemed like we got the energy that the night was a lot of like opening up and talking. It didn't necessarily seem so spicy. It seemed a little more like, hey, we let the walls down more and had these conversations, because we end up finding out from Rachel that she did tell him that she's in love with him.
Right.
So it probably was a lot of long conversations and opening up, because I'll say like it did. The morning definitely didn't seem awkward. They seemed like good and romantic, but it didn't seem like how he was.
When you see the comparison
with Kelsey and Daisy.
When you saw
the
comparison, you were like, oh.
With Kelsey and Daisy, it was a lot of putting them on counters and making out with them.
Yes.
And Rachel and Joey, there was a lot of like, oh, they're processing and like, you know, talking about.
He also said like, last night was really good. It was really nice to like connect.
Yes.
But it wasn't like it was really nice to connect.
Yes, it definitely seemed more like an emotional connection piece with the two of them. But when he left her, she seemed nervous.
Yeah.
Which made...
There was a moment when they, like, he walked away and she went...
I know. She took a deep breath. Yeah. And like, and I'll say this. If I wouldn't have seen in the Kelsey and Daisy dates after, I would have been like, I thought the date, other than the fact that poor Rachel got absolutely like obliterated, I was like, I feel like it went really well. And in the morning, they seemed comfortable and very much vibing with each other. And so I would have been like, oh, great, amazing. But then after then seeing what seemed to be quite a chemistry vibe in the morning with Kelsey and Daisy, it seems like.
Agreed.
Yeah. Then we have Kelsey. Mm-hmm. Before we talk about Kelsey, let's take another quick pause. Family, I'll tell you what. If I was on this show and living out of hotel rooms, do you know what I would miss? I would miss my daily harvest, okay? When it comes to eating well, it's a total guessing game. Even if something is easy to prep and looks good for me, the label is full of ingredients I've been trying to avoid for my insides. That's why I love Daily Harvest. They say no to things like gluten, fillers, seed oils, and more. So all I have to do is say yes to delicious, easy to prep smoothies that never leave me wondering what's really in my food. It is so cool and so delicious and easy. I'm telling you all, if I could get the mint and cacao Daily Harvest smoothie on tap, I would be chugging that thing all day long. It's just so good. We love Daily Harvest.
Daily Harvest really takes the guesswork and effort out of cooking because they deliver delicious smoothies and other options that are built on organic fruits and vegetables straight to our door. We get the best smoothies and meals that are ready in minutes without the trouble of shopping, prepping, or the cleanup, which is my biggest problem, the cleanup. When it comes to variety, Daily Harvest is always keeping it exciting, too. They have so many great options. I really never get bored when it comes to the meals and snacks.
Seriously, it feels like they have a never-ending variety of deliciousness. I have my forever fave go-tos, of course. But recently, I tried their black sesame and banana smoothie, and it, like, knocked my socks off. Unreal. It was so good. Also, I love, 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 love their forager bowls. Their vanilla bean and apple bowl is my new favorite. And oh my gosh, I just tried their pops just in time for the warmer weather, the spring and the summer. They are so good. Okay. The mango passion fruit flavor. Fantastic. Also, by using only recyclable or compostable packaging when possible, Daily Harvest is doing their part to take care of our earth, which helps me limit my waste. Take the guessing out of eating well and try Daily Harvest for a limited time only. Go to dailyharvest.com/momdad to get $30 off your first box plus free shipping. That's dailyharvest.com/momdad for $30 off your first box and free shipping. dailyharvest.com/momdad. Okay, on to Kelsey next. Okay, by the way, also, I just had a thought when it comes to Rachel. Yeah. Like, the idea of having what happened to her earlier in the day and then be like, are you ready for fantasy suites? It's literally like, do you want to go to this fantasy suite after, like, being maybe concussed and having your face bashed in?
And also
in?
To make out. Oh. It's not really good to make out when your jaw's busted.
Well, think about Jimmy from Love is Blind with his taquito incident. There's no way. I mean, he had a taquito incident and he couldn't kiss anybody for like two,
couldn't have
two,
sex for weeks. Week.
Rachel just experienced a full obliteration jumping off into the cenote. My goodness.
Yeah, actually, I didn't think about that. If your jaw was messed up, it would be hard to kiss. So, like, that could have also ruined the, like, vibe, too.
Well, it also, you're uncomfortable. She's
Joey's
probably,
like, it's cool. I can, we don't have to kiss.
We also probably had a Rachel who was maybe on pain medication, too. And so it's like, we're just going to be talking.
Yeah, really did sabotage her whole thing.
Yeah, no, I didn't even think about that part. Yeah. Dang. Dang. All right. Well, Kelsey is next, and Kelsey has her golden lady come to visit her, and it
the Grim
is
Reaper.
That is so sad. It's Leslie. You know what I saw? I saw Kelsey post, and she was like, "I'm so thankful to Leslie.
Yeah.
She really reminded me in our conversation that no matter what happens, like how valuable I am at the end. Please be kind." I guess people are like coming at Leslie.
Like,
for like, you know, coming in, you know, bringing some you know,
some
potentially
bad vibes. It was just like, hey, listen.
But
this process ruined my life. Okay. So you're probably going to end up devastated, crushed, broken, surprised, blindsided.
She did go on for a while with the list.
And, you know, this process, I'm still not recovered from this process. And Tulum is I'm drinking in Tulum, and that's about the only fun thing that's happening right now. But have fun tonight And don't let these ideas haunt your dreams. No, I'm just kidding. But no, but there was this level of, I did feel a little bit like, okay, I think it's good to remember, Leslie, like, take all your frustrations and all your life and all that, and then filter it, distill it into something usable, other than just don't commit fully to this process because you might get burned.
I felt like she did a really good job.
I felt like I appreciated the message, but to someone who's like super fragile on like fantasy week, it's a little bit like, how about we say, I learned so much about myself, as much as, you know, these things can be hard, I don't regret it. It was, you know what I mean? Kind of like finding some positive.
What I'm saying is, but I think like that was included. It's like sending someone
into like a job interview being like, oh, here's the craziest worst story that ever happened to me. Anyway, good luck. And you're just like,
but you know, I think
it was just a little like, okay.
But I think that was partially editing, because it seems like Kelsey made it seem like Leslie did do a lot of encouraging. Yes. And then they showed, of course,
they're like,
her, like,
they're like, we'll cut that shit out.
We need to focus on it. Yeah. Now, part of me wondered, because Leslie definitely was like really laying it all out there, I was like, did this maybe hurt her chances for becoming Golden Bachelorette? I don't know if like.
Oh, I don't think Leslie would have been ever Golden Bachelorette.
Really? You don't think so?
No, I think that...
Well, you still don't know. They haven't announced.
That's true. I just never thought that would be a possibility.
Oh, I definitely thought that she was
It was
like
too heavy and gnarly. And then afterwards, she kind of talked about him and was kind of like saying, he lied to me. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, it wasn't like... It wasn't like a clean ending.
Yeah, no, true. I was thinking that there was a possibility. And so when she then was saying like this process, like it broke me essentially, I was like, oh, I wonder if that's then the franchise is kind of going, okay, now she's not going to be Golden Bachelorette.
Like, she's like, he broke me. And then she turns and she goes, and that's why coming this fall. And then she announces. But yeah, the one thing I will say was beautiful though, was like, the fact that both their moms had passed away and the fact that they could connect over there, and then Leslie could bring like encouragement and love and kind of say, hey, she's proud of you, and all that was very heartwarming and intense.
I thought Leslie came in and literally
beautiful.
Was like a warm hug 100%. For her. Was like, I see you. And then she was like, I just like, again, letting her know like, hey, your mom would be 100%. So proud, and almost being like a motherly type presence. And not only that, when she walked in, Evan looked at me and he goes, did future Kelsey just walk in on Kelsey?
Yeah.
Like, he was like, the idea. Like, Leslie looks like an older version of Kelsey. And it was almost like Kelsey looking at herself in however many years and being like the future self coming in and being like, be careful.
Like, that probably didn't help. If they would have had Susan in there or something, someone who looks very different than her, it would have helped. But like, the fact that she was looking at her and being like, me? Am I saying this? It's like, you know what I mean? Marty McFly coming back to warn himself.
Back to the future.
You know
what I mean? Just like, make sure. That's what it felt like.
Keep a little bit of yourself behind.
That's 100% what it felt like when they were looking at each other. I was like, wow, it's like looking into a mirror just in the future. But I felt like in general, she was very, very lovely.
Yeah.
But some of the comments like, I wouldn't have felt so confident, you know, if I would have known going in, after Kelsey being like, I feel so confident after him meeting my family. She's like, I wouldn't have felt so confident if I knew that he was lying to me this entire time.
Basically, like I said, you can't trust anyone. That's kind of what she was saying. And it's a little bit like, okay, like I get the messaging, but at the same time, like you're putting her in a spot where like she's not going to commit. And if you're not going to commit, you're not going to be able to like be a part of this process. Well, it was a little like.
And I was saying, it makes total sense that was in the conversation that it was had with Kelsey, because Kelsey, it's been smooth sailing and everything's been like, we're good, we're good, we're good. Clearly her and Joey are vibing that it's like, okay, we got to throw a loop in here because she's been okay with this process the whole time. So now it's time to really rattle her up.
The farthest, most smooth sailing person on the whole show.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So she's rattled.
Yeah.
She's tripping out and she's like, oh my God. And this happens before the date.
Yeah. Cause Leslie said like, there was no doubt in my mind it was me. And then Kelsey's going, wait, I have no doubt in my mind it's me either. You know, it was
parallel.
Well placed.
It
by
was
whoever.
Parallel. But she has her one-on-one date after.
Yeah.
Okay. So, which I think is good, because I thought that was going to come after.
Like in between date and dinner, in between date and fantasy suite is Leslie.
No, I was thinking after.
Oh God.
Where
yeah,
she's
that's
feeling
true.
Great. And
that's
all of a sudden true. Leslie shows up and is like, I thought it was going to be me too.
It was great for me too.
He also told me. Now. Okay. So then we have Kelsey go on her one-on-one with Joey, and we hear Joey saying all these things like, the way that Kelsey makes me feel is so different. I don't know if she feels the way about me. It almost is like, Joe, from Joey's perspective, he's like, I'm all in with Kelsey. I can't quite tell if Kelsey's all in with me, which was a surprising one to me. I didn't know if I necessarily read that before. But they get to go on a yacht. See, this is what I'm saying. Okay. I know that you were saying the cenote date is beautiful, which it was, but it's also just like, can we tune down the adventure for the fantasy suite portion? Like maybe not the ATVs and the jumping off of platforms, maybe like the yacht energy, maybe the like high tea energy, maybe the snorkeling, maybe the floating in the water, laying by the pool energy, massages at the hotel energy, not like potentially like your life in danger vibes. Right. That's all I'm saying.
I agree. That was very... Yeah, you would have enjoyed the second one. Kelsey's did a lot more.
I would have liked that one a lot more. But they went on the yacht and, you know, he asks her the like really wild, pressing, confusing questions like, would you like a house on the water? He asks her, would you like a house on the water? Like, who says no?
No.
Would you like a house on the water someday?
No, I want a house behind a restaurant.
Would you someday be interested in owning a house that's worth, you know, upwards of $5 million at minimum?
Does that interest you? I'm just trying to get to know you. Yeah, that interests me.
Yeah, dude. Sounds great.
Anyone. Do you like pizza? Chances are yes.
I feel like that's even a wilder
question.
Yeah, that's
even wilder. No one's ever
been
like...
Would you like a house on the water? Are you interested in owning a mansion one day? I mean, like, what?
Yeah, that is an interesting question because it's like, it's the least controversial of all the housing options, right? A house in the mountains. You're like, maybe I'm not a mountain person or like an outdoorsy person. A house in the city. You know, I like a quieter type.
Yeah.
No one ever said, house by the water? Gross.
Yuck.
Gross.
Get your money away from me.
It's not even a money thing. Even if they were all even, it's like, get your serene, gorgeous sea breeze away from me. It's like, no one's ever said that.
You know what I mean?
Like,
I hate
get your sunset and shove it up your ass. I don't want anything to do with a gorgeous sunset, seagulls squawking, and the sea breeze kissing my face as I sip champagne. I don't want it.
Yeah, give Mother Nature's salty breath out of my fucking face.
Oh, salty nature's salty breath. Wow, I like that. Okay.
Well, you know, I look into cameras and I'm a poet. I don't know what to tell you. But then they pull up and they see these underwater shots of they're about to dive in stingrays or manta rays, turtles, sharks, absolutely stunning. They jump in, they're kissing above it.
Yeah. It's a very romantic date.
I at first was like, they better give them snorkeling gear because if they're just like kissing above like this incredibly gorgeous wildlife,
they're just opening up their eyes to this water.
The contacts are flying out. But like, I could think about was as soon as they pulled up, Kelsey is just oh so joyful. Yeah. It's like if you thought she was excited for the polar plunge, she then sees these animals and she's screaming about the manta ray.
She is kind of the dream woman when it comes to reactions.
Yeah, 100%.
Like she's great. You give her like a necklace for her birthday and she's just like, yeah! And you're like, yes. She's whatever the opposite of like, thank you, is. She's the reaction queen.
You're like, oh, guess what? For our anniversary, we're going out to this restaurant. And she's like, stop it. Stop it. You know that I've been wanting to go
there.
You
know Cheesecake Factory is my favorite.
Stop it.
Yeah. She's great if you're looking for a little ego boost, reaction boost.
And Joey, because his whole thing is like, I want to be loved. Like, she has to make you feel so loved.
She really makes you feel
special. Every step you take, every move you make, she will be watching you joyfully.
Whoa. Was that halfway through the sentence? You realized what you were doing? Uh-huh. Whoa, that was... elite.
I've been doing this for a few years.
That was elite.
I might slur and stumble over all my words and say like constantly, but
like halfway through your sentence you realize you were saying lyrics to a song and you didn't even turn it into a song. You just kept talking and then you rapped it. That was insane.
Thank you.
Okay.
They're just make out central. They can't stop making
out. He's definitely to me the most erotically attracted to her. That's the vibe I get.
The sexuality is pretty through the roof with the two of them. And then when they end up getting to the night portion, you know, they're still macking. Now, when they get to the night portion, we got some interesting dynamic that goes down. She right away tells Joey that she talked to Leslie and reminded him kind of a little bit of Leslie's story of what happened with Leslie and Gary. And he then brings up Charity and how he's like, I was 100% sure it was going to be me. She tells him that she loves him. It ends up coming out.
Yeah.
She says, I'm in love with you. And he then says that he is falling in love with her fully.
Yeah.
This is the first time we've heard Joey say anything of the sort. Okay. In general, Joey, even last episode during Hometowns, was like, there's a reason I haven't been saying anything because I want to protect everyone's heart because my heart, and I felt like I was the one and then it wasn't the case and da 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 da. So I was thinking that Joey was going to not say this until the very end because, you know, we're a few days away from a proposal. I didn't think he was going to say it. I thought he was going to keep it close to his vest. He ends up telling Kelsey, I am falling in love with you fully. He doubles down. He keeps emphasizing it. Now, this is what rattled me. He says this to her right after she tells him about what Leslie told her. And then Joey says, I was really hurt by Charity because I was 100% sure. Mm-hmm. So when Joey then tells her this, all I could think about is Joey, you better not say it to Daisy because you just heard from Kelsey. I'm feeling these certain ways. Leslie came in and reminded me that like she felt bamboozled by Gary. And then Joey's like, yeah, hey, same. I felt like I was 100% it. And then it broke my heart. By the way, I am falling in love with you fully. So I'm like, Joey, it better be Kelsey.
Also,
but then I was confident that he wasn't going to say it to Daisy. And then he says it to Daisy.
He says it to Daisy, too.
And I'm like, why do you guys do this? Why? Why can't you resist?
I think it's penis.
Why can't you just keep your mouth shut?
I think it's penis. It's like we start thinking with it. You know what I mean? And you're just kind of like, I love you. You know, because it's like you start getting like in it and then you just start blabbering like all the what do you call it? All the like decorum and like strategy goes out the window.
Oh,
so I honestly think it's like he's in the, you know, he's been making out with her all day. He's about to go to bed with her that tonight and they're about to hook up and he's feeling all the tension and
he's
falling in love with her. And instead of just kind of keeping it all, like he's been so strategically correct. Now he lets it all go. You know, also saying it's funny. Saying I'm falling in love with you fully is like saying it works 70% of the time every time.
Because he didn't say I'm in love with you.
Yeah, he said I'm falling in love with you fully. It's just like saying I'm fully in love with you. Like you can't fully fall.
But he's making sure that he's using those technical terms.
I'm falling in love with you all the way fully in every way.
But not fully in love.
It's like, please, you're in love.
But I'm just like, guys, can we just keep it together for just a second? Like, just hold on to it for just two more days.
Because I think he realizes I got to say it or else she might run away.
Right.
That's the vibe I'm getting.
Sure. But I'm just like, if he wouldn't have said it to Daisy, I would have been like, okay, then this is who he's choosing, right?
Yeah.
But the fact then that he right away then afterwards said it to Daisy. No, it was a little less. He was like, I'm falling in love with you. And it was like, he didn't double down quite as much. He didn't give her quite all the love levels, right? As Game of Roses says, the love levels weren't all the way as much there as they were with Kelsey. But I'm still just like, Joey, after hearing what she just said to you, she reminded you of the Leslie story. Be careful with your words. Damn. All right, we got to take one last quick pause, then we'll get into it. Family, so if I was on this show, I love doing that. I love saying if I was on this show, it's one of my most favorite things, but for real, if I was on this show, the first thing I would be packing in my suitcase, this is a fact, would be my Vegamore products. I'm telling you all, 4 years now, I will not go on any trip without my Vegamore products because they changed my hair game for me big time. You all know this. Real change happens when you're consistent and achieving the hair of your dreams is no exception. Thanks to Vegamore, sticking to my hair routine has never been easier. And you all know that I've been seeing these results for years and I am so, so grateful to Vegamore.
Vegamore products are 100% cruelty-free and are never formulated with potentially harmful chemicals like parabens or hormones. And remember, when it comes to seeing results, the key is consistency. For best results, use for a minimum 3 months for visibly fuller, healthier, and thicker looking hair.
Yes, I think around 3 months is when I started seeing some of those seriously visible results. And like I said, I have not stopped since using it because it changed my hair game for me. I also love how easy Vegamore makes it to stay consistent. Their shampoo and conditioner are all I use. And I have a monthly subscription of their Grow Serum. When I sign up for a monthly subscription, I can get one bottle or three bottles sent. Plus, I save more and I never run low on the products I need to take care of my hair. And I love their hair growth serum. It personally never makes my hair oily, which is hugely helpful for me when it comes to consistency. And fun fact, Vegamore sells one bottle of grow hair serum every 15 seconds on their website. That's how good this stuff is, okay? Elevate your hair wellness routine this year with Vegamore. For a limited time, get 20% off your first subscription order by going to vegamore.com/momdad and use code momdad at checkout. That's vegamore.com/momdad, code momdad, to save 20% on your first order. vegamore.com/momdad, code mom dad. All right, so back to Kelsey and Joey. So yes, he then tells her that he is falling in love fully, and they are whisked away to their fantasy suite where we see them macking, and then we get them the next morning. We don't get them in bed. They're now eating. And they are full rom-com mode. Mm-hmm. They are in a full rom-com. They are giggling. It was a full rom-com. They are giggling around the kitchen. He's cooking. She's laughing at him. They're making out in between bites. He's putting her on the counter and making out with her. Like, our eyes are all hearts. They're in love.
It looked like an ad for,
Folgers?
Like dick pills.
Oh my God. You know what I mean? Like, I say Folgers and you go dick pills. It's like a Blue Chew ad or like a Viagra ad.
Didn't it look like that? It's like you too could have this, and they're like picking her up on the counter and they're making out and like
it's
flipping
eggs. A Viagra ad, yeah.
You know what I mean? It was like, look what you could have if you take our pill. You know what I mean? Like, that was, it literally had the, like, you know, your everything will change. Energy.
Yeah, no, if you would have cut their speaking and put that music over it with like a, you know, don't take over.
Don't take over the counter.
If you're over 50 years old, don't take over the counter.
Don't take horny goat weed at the gas station. Take our pill and then you'll be hot like them.
Don't take, that's 9 p.m. If over the age of 50, like, you can hear
your
that.
Your erection lasts for 14 hours. Yeah. Please call the ambulance. Like, it definitely had, like, you know.
It did. And they were like,
because it was so perfect. It was literally,
it
like,
was so perfect.
They're just flipping eggs, being cute, laughing at some point. They're making out on the counter. Like, it was picturesque.
It really was. I feel like he can't stop smiling. He was this morning when he woke up with Kelsey. It was like he was beaming ear to ear, and they can't stop smiling. There is an electricity, a pulsation
there.
They
didn't just stay up all night chatting.
Well, we don't know, okay? But it just definitely, it felt quite electric.
Yes.
And there was a lot of chemistry. Like I said, he was putting her, mm-hmm. Putting her on the counter, making out with her. It was a lot of makeouts that were just continuing. It was a vibe.
Yes.
Man, I'm like, I look at something like that and I go, wow, they must have had such a dreamy fantasy suite night, and it must have been so romantic and sexy. I'm like, truly, if I took someone to the fantasy suite, I know that I've joked about, like, oh, well, it's not a joke, it's true, but I'd be like, we'd be just eating in bed. I'd be like, are you down with me just like eating all these Cheetos in bed, blah, 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 blah. But like, the truth of the matter, it's like a fantasy suite with me would be like, here's a test. We're going to get in bed, turn the lights off, and I'm going to see how you handle me laying in bed and having a full panic attack about, like, what happens when I die, because that's what you're going to have to get used to every single night. That's the reality of the situation, my guy. Like, will you be able to handle me having a
I'm
full
not gonna make you
anxiety existential crisis every single night? No, I'm not pulling one over on you. I'm not going to trick you. I'm going to be like, this is what you're going to get.
I'm giving you the 10
this
years
is
the
reality.
In.
Yeah, no, this is 6 days out of the week, honey. Yeah. Maybe on the seventh, we have, a night where I fall asleep watching TV quietly. Other than that, it's anxiety central. We're not falling asleep with you stroking my hair every night, looking into my eyes, and us like casually talking about how much we love each other. Yeah. Like, I'm gonna have anxiety. What are you gonna do about it? Are you my person or not?
Am I dying? How do you handle that? It's huge. It's like, what? Listen. This is going to be
every night
a
I'm going to think that I'm
outpouring
dying
of the fear of death.
How are you going to handle
that? How are you going to handle that everything reminds me that my time here is limited? How do you feel about the fact that every heartbeat might be your last? this is a Tuesday, mind you. He's like, oh, why did you don't stress about it. Oh, okay, that's what you're gonna say to me. Don't stress about it.
You're out immediately.
Then your worst nightmare is gonna come true. I'm leaving.
Oh my god. Clearly that's not what happened in their fantasy suite is all I'm saying. So good for them that they had some romantic, non-realistic night together. Okay. Good for them.
Because y'all know what marriage is. It's one person thinking they're going to die and the other person rolling their eyes at them going, I don't know, babe. I don't know. That's marriage. That's true love. And if you don't subscribe,
oh my gosh,
true love is someone going, did you lock the door when you're just about to fall asleep?
Oh my gosh, that makes me so hurt.
That's so funny.
Well, guess what? They say a goodbye together. It's romantic.
Yeah.
They're making out. By the way,
I love you. She says it like a normal way too.
They say it in like kind of a casual almost way. Now that they're throwing it around when they're making out, it looks like they are one hair. Mm-hmm. By the way, like their hair joins together and it becomes like one unit. Mm-hmm. They are already
a hair
under the eyes of God. They are one hair, one unit.
Yes. Gosh, just like that one.
That's funny.
They are a hair. They are hair.
So that's how they end. But whilst then Daisy is having Daisy is having her date with Joey, the final fantasy suite.
Yeah.
We see that Kelsey begins to spiral. It's like the date went so well, and now everything that Leslie's saying is getting in her head. She's remembering what Leslie said about what Gary did to her, and she's now thinking
Leslie drops a note off after their fantasy suite. It says, remember. It says, don't remember to hold a small piece of yourself back, because the rest will be laid waste, and you'll need that small piece to grow back. Just remember that in the ashes, a small piece, as long as you keep a small seed of yourself, we can rebuild.
She definitely left another note, by the way, or like wrote with lipstick on her mirror, like, don't forget, like,
the
remember
pain
what
will be
I
worse
said
than a thousand arrows descending upon you. Know that whatever pain you've gone through is nothing compared to what is awaiting you on the other side of this.
But she starts absolutely spiraling, and that's then when we see her considering like what she's going to say to Joey. She's like, I'd rather leave now than be heartbroken.
Right.
And that's when she goes, we have like the camera view of like the hotel, you know, the hotel lot or a hallway camera view of her going and knocking on Joey's door while it seems like he's at his date with Daisy, knocking on the door. He's not answering. And then she writes a note and she puts the note in there. And, you know, I think I have a theory. I don't know. It's tough because for Joey, it's like, does he love her enough that she might be doing what he considers the unforgivable sin, which is threatening leaving?
Yeah.
And if she threatens to leave, we'll see how much Joey loves her.
Yeah.
If he's like, no, please stay, or like, I'll leave with you. Or if that pushes him over the edge to be like, I reject you because you have committed the unforgivable sin.
Yeah, the old Maria.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Which might happen. I don't foresee it with him because I think he like really is in love with Kelsey. But I also feel like my guess is, God, I don't know. I was going to say it's either that like they end up having a conversation and she's like, please let me know. Please let me know that you're not going to break my heart. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to just send me home now before the rose ceremony. And then he's like, no, I'm going to be keeping you. And then she stays and they made it this way bigger of a drama than it had to be.
Yeah.
Or she leaves.
Either way, she's not leaving before, in my opinion, the rose. Like,
you don't think
so? No, because it's like, if she leaves now, then what? Then I guess Rachel or Daisy would have the one to leave him on the altar. And none of them seem like that's the case right now, unless they're just...
I don't know. Daisy seems... I don't know. Daisy could leave him. Rachel could too. She's spiraling. She's feeling nervous.
My thought is this. Talks with Kelsey. Says, I need to think about it. Okay. And then the next time they talk is going to be at the rose ceremony or not. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Will she show up or no?
It's a will she show up or not.
Okay. All right. Huh.
Like, that's the cliffhanger, is that she doesn't show up to the rose ceremony after they talk. She's not going to leave before the rose ceremony. She's going to leave at the rose ceremony after they talked, and he's kind of waiting to wonder if she shows up.
I think this is being way more dramatized than it. Than that's my guess. Mm. My guess is that this is being blown out of proportion. It's not actually that big of a deal that they're going to sit down and talk together, and she's going to be like, "I'm so into you. I'm really, really nervous. Like, please don't break my heart. I'd rather leave than have my heart broken if I'm not the one. Please let me know I really am." And he's like, "Baby, I told you that I'm already falling fully in love with you. Like, I'm not going to let you go." One. But yeah. By the way, when we then see Joey get the letter later, which just says we need to talk, he's in ITMs full spiral.
Yeah.
He already in ITMs is just like, "I knew this was going to happen again." I'm like, Joey, you don't even necessarily know what she's going to say.
That's true.
Maybe she has a big secret to reveal.
Yeah.
Maybe she's been hiding something this whole time and she's like, "We need to talk." That's and true. She's just like, "Hey, by the way, you know, I'm a twin." I mean, I don't know. Like, I mean, my twin have been switching places this whole time. It's Kelsey A and Chelsea A, and we've been switching, and you thought it was just me. But I mean, maybe that's what
that's
it is.
True. It's possible. I doubt it, babe.
But what I'm saying
babe. Bad theory, I doubt it.
But what I'm saying is him in the ITMs being like, "This always happens, right. It always happens," and he's crying already and spiraling is a little bit like, okay, hold up, Joey. I know what it seems like, but we still don't 100% know yet. So him coming in with that energy also might be bad.
That's true.
He might be like, "Get out of my
sight."
That's
kind of what he's been doing
to commit the unforgivable
one.
Sin.
He's just being a little negative, Nancy, about this topic.
Yeah.
It's like, bro, everyone loves
you. Everybody wants to date you.
Yeah, like, it's not a problem. Just start owning this. Start owning this process.
Yeah.
What's the only thing? It's like, you're literally the bachelor.
Yeah, be the bachelor.
Be the bachelor. Like, own this process.
But again, you know, in general, I would appreciate being with a lead who
I appreciate the humility. I appreciate the humility, but it's more, that's my message for him, not for every bachelor.
But again, this is my whole thing, okay? And maybe I'm going to get heat for this, but like, when he's saying that and saying like, my biggest fear is that someone is going to like, you know, leave me and it's going to be like last time where I say I'm in love and then they ditch me.
Yeah.
I'm like, you are so afraid of that. And yet you told Kelsey and Daisy that you were falling for them.
Yeah.
So how do you think that's going to make one of them feel?
Yeah.
Shouldn't you be the one who's like hyper aware of the fact that you were really, really hurt? If that's like your big thing,
right,
then you should have really not said anything. If that's something that's like a big trigger for you, you should know better than to say that to them yet. That was what really kind of turned me off.
I've
loved Joey.
Like,
I really have. And I feel like he's done a phenomenal job. But this was like, no.
Don't do the same thing.
You know what it's like to be on the other side.
Yeah.
You know, and feel that pain. So if you don't want to feel that pain again, then don't potentially mess with someone else's heart in that way. Even if you are feeling, even if he does fully feel like he's in love with all of them.
Yeah.
Just, you know, just be careful with some of your words beforehand so that it doesn't make it worse.
Agreed. Entirely.
That's all I'm saying.
Okay. I agree.
Anyway, we'll see. But back to Daisy.
Yeah.
Daisy and Joey, they have, before they have their final date, Daisy gets to chat with Sandra. And Sandra is absolutely cracking me up because
she's just like, "Listen, start saying stuff like, don't you love practice? I can't wait to start practicing making babies with you. Because listen, guys, sex for guys is so different, okay? So you got to understand this, that like, she went old school on her. She's like, guys' brains when it comes to sex is so different than women. And that's just, trust me on this. It was really funny.
It was cracking me up because she started where
she
was
just a conversation you've had like with your parents at some point.
Yeah,
like,
but she started off where she was just like giving like great advice and being there for her. And, you know, and Daisy was starting to cry and she's like, "I feel like I have like someone there from like my family with me." And she's like, "I feel like I'm talking to one of my own daughters." It was so sweet. And then, out of left field, she just like start bringing up topics like, "Let's practice making babies together."
It was kind of one of those like, "Cool, feelings are great, but no one cares. This is what you need to do." It was kind of funny. It was just compared to all the other conversations.
Yeah, it was so.
She comes
funny.
In with just,
but we
listen.
Knew because
she's
Sandra
always been like
is
that.
Always the one.
She's
the
horn dog.
Like,
of
she's
the crew.
Always just like, "Well, let me tell you about something."
I have some techniques. Yeah, she's hilarious.
She is so funny. But they were super, super cute because then at the end, she was just like, "I hope it's Daisy, fingers crossed." Like, she was getting attached.
Yeah, it's funny too because, you know, Daisy's just so like, "Oh, okay, you know, and then Sandra's coming in, "Listen." You know, like the energy could not have been more just like, like they put the opposites together on that one. That was funny.
Daisy's just kind of like, yeah, I haven't really opened up too much to him. I've kind of been holding back. And Sandra's like, that's fine. Just talk about the baby making process. Yeah,
here's what you gotta do.
Anywho, listen though. Daisy loved Sandra and loved her advice because Daisy starts the date off where they, her and Joey meet up and Joey's like, are you ready? And she's like, yeah, hold up 1 second. Grabs his face, starts sensually making out with him, which hasn't been Daisy's necessary go-to is being like,
she's been a little bit like chase me energy.
Yeah. Like letting him go in for the smoochies and all of this. And in this time she was like, I took a note from Queen Sandra and I am going to take initiative and I'm going to, I'm going to lay one on him, you know, and let him know I stand.
Big time.
And I feel like Sandra's advice actually was really, really good for Daisy because Daisy had been holding back in this whole fantasy suite. Daisy leaned in to that piece, to the chemistry piece. And I felt like it did end up making their date quite, you know, the chemistry was, it was pulsating with this date too.
She definitely stepped into some new energy.
New energies, new territories. So, you know, they end up going on their ATVs and they're having their wild time together, their adventuring time together. But then they sit down together and they're doing a lot of, he does the don't look at me like that. Which, like, by the way, that's the it's a potion of words.
Yeah.
If you're in any situation and there's a little bit of chemistry and the person across from you goes, kind of smirks and goes, don't look at me like that. Yeah. It's like everyone's heart drops.
And
everyone
could
flutters.
Be worse than if you're like on a date that you hate and and he just looks over and goes, don't look at me like that. Like, oh my God, I can't wait to get the hell out of here. Like, could you imagine someone saying that to you when you're like completely icked? And they're like, don't look at me like that. You mean like with disgust? Okay, sorry. Like, stop. You're dangerous. Oh, that just hit me though. I was just thinking, I was like, if someone said that to me and I was very not into them, that would send chills down my spine. Yet if you're into them, it's like incredible.
I would just immediately, if I wasn't into them, I would just immediately put sunglasses on. I'd be like, okay, you cannot see my eyes. Yeah. And apparently I'm giving off an energy. But yeah, when he threw that out, I was like, okay, Joey. When he threw that out, I was like, Joey's trying the moves right now. He's Joey's got the don't look at me like that in his back pocket. Yeah. I'm like, I see you. I see some of your moves, big Joey.
Yeah.
And then he's like, I got a little surprise for you. And his surprise is that he takes her to an open air shower and they start sucking face.
Yeah, it was very.
Like, his surprise for her. By the way, I have a surprise for you. And he takes her to a shower. Wild. Right?
Yeah, it was like,
I thought there was
like
gonna be like a monkey or something.
It was like, I'm the prize. It was like, I have a surprise for you, and he just like shows his abs. And he's like, you wanna eat cake off these bad boys?
Gross.
You know what I mean though? He had that energy of like, I have a surprise for you. It's your lucky day, and then he's like coming in. You know what I mean? Like, it had a little bit of like remember in The Office when one of my favorite scenes is Pam when she's dating not Jim yet, but she's dating Roy.
Yeah.
And he's like he forgot it was Valentine's Day, and then she goes, you forgot it was Valentine's. He goes, Valentine's Day is not over, babe. You're gonna get the best sex of your life tonight. And she's like, oh, thanks. I have a surprise for you.
Flexes. But right, I have a little surprise for you. It's an open air shower.
It's like, that's the surprise for you, big guy.
But they start
they're warming up the evening.
Yeah, they are making out in this open air shower. Mm-hmm. It is getting very, very spicy. And I feel like they don't stop making out except for one moment. Then during the night portion when they're in their Valentine's Day, like matching type outfits. Yeah. And she was talking about how she's like, man, you know, I wish that you saw me more when I was more emotional. Yeah. And she's like, yeah, this morning, I had to write this down to make me laugh so hard. She goes, yeah, this morning I was crying to Sandra, that golden bachelor lady who I don't even like know.
Like, yeah, that was
that golden bachelor lady. That crap.
That's like,
up.
I didn't watch the show and I've barely seen this whole, any of this, to be honest with you. I've never actually seen this franchise once. So there's like this golden lady.
that she descended from the heavens.
They sent a golden lady to me. Yeah. And I don't know what the golden thing is, but, you know, anyway, she talked to me. She's very nice. She's very horny. but I mean, very nice still.
But then she was just like, yeah, you know, you haven't seen, like, I cry all the time. I'm super emotional. And how she talks about how she's been shut down in the past from exes. And, you know, Joey shares his insecurities. She starts crying for a moment.
Yeah.
And they're having this open, vulnerable time together. And then he says that he is falling in love with her. And there you go. And that's when I was like, oh boy. Because I was pretty convinced when he said it to Kelsey, I was like, he's not going to say it to anybody else. And we're going to now have a clear front runner energy. And that's what's going to be like the remainder of this. So then we're all scratching our heads about what happens in the end where he's sobbing. That's what I thought the narrative was going to be. Like, we hear him say it to Kelsey. We have a clear front runner as the audience. And then all of a sudden she's like, I'm going to leave. But then maybe she stays. But then we're like, how does it end? But then I was shocked when then he also said to Daisy, I am falling in love with you. And now I'm like, whoa, this is not great.
Yeah.
Because the energy that he had for the whole date in general, I was surprised by, because his date was so great with Kelsey as far as their chemistry went. And he was so beaming.
Yeah.
He kind of transitioned that into his date with Daisy. He was beaming throughout this whole date too. And so it became what like seemed like, oh, Kelsey's front runner to, I mean, I don't know. Kelsey still seems like a little bit like front runner, but between him and Daisy, or between her and Daisy, it feels a little neck and neck for Joey. And so then, he says he's falling in love with her. They end up taking it to the fantasy suite after Jesse extends his card, his lucky card to them. And they're continuing to make out.
Yeah.
They have more makeout scenes and more makeout scenes. The next morning, they're in bed, he doubles down on the love, which you look at me and you go, uh-oh, he's pulling a Gary. He's doubling down on it the next morning.
He's love dumping on everyone.
It's a little bit like, oh no, it wasn't
he
just
unleashed,
like, now
it's like there was like a gate and the gate got blown open and he's like, I love everybody.
He's just letting everybody know, and now he can't stop. Now it's like a river flowing from him. And when they say goodbye, by the way, I mean, it is, it's a spicy makeout, and she seems confident.
She seems a lot more oozy.
Yes.
For the first time, she's a lot more like, you've unleashed something in me.
Now, Daisy's been on the fence, it seems, to the viewers, at least.
Kind of a nut, hard nut to crack.
Yeah, energy. A little more of a slow burn. It was like, you got to get my parents' permission, or not your parents' permission, but you got to get like my parents' approval for me to feel. And now it's like, now that she's opened that door up, it seems like she feels pretty confident in it. But I still feel like watching it between him and Kelsey, there seems more like relationship and chemistry. And with Daisy, it just feels pretty spicy right now. That was more of the energy I was getting, where there was that type of chemistry more there.
Big time.
And then with him and Rachel, it feels like, just because she was a little bit delayed, I feel like he might have been in that same spot with her too, if the feelings wouldn't have been as delayed. And also if the date would have gone differently.
Yeah.
If she would have had the opportunity to have like a yacht situation and not had to go to the hospital. You know what I mean? But that's then when he ends up saying goodbye to Daisy, and he does make a comment on his exit with Daisy that I wrote down that also made me giggle. He said something like, he came into this with fear that no woman would love him, and now I have three women who can't imagine a life without me.
Yeah, I love the idea.
Which
that,
I know what he means.
Yeah, he didn't mean like that, but I do love the idea that he once he kind of goes over the edge, he becomes like an egomaniac. And he's like, now,
like, can't imagine
now that they've been physical with me, they've seen what I'm capable of, and they're going to lose their minds, and they'll never be able to have sex again for the rest of their lives, because it'll all just be a devastating disappointment forever. So now that I've done that to them,
now I have three women who can't imagine a life without me.
It was definitely like a slip up of how that was delivered.
I know.
That was
hilarious. I know he didn't mean it that way, but I had to I stopped it and rewound it.
I can't break up with you because you'd be too devastated.
Yeah, exactly. That was the vibe.
Yeah.
But I know it was an accident. It was an accident. But then, yes, again, we go back to the Kelsey of it all. And she's talking about how she would rather leave than have her heart broken. And he sees that note and he starts spiraling. I mean, yeah. By the way, the hallway of it all was yeah. oh so creepy. It looked like one of the contestants was going to go kill him. It was very yes. spooky. It did not feel romantic in the slightest. No. It was definitely like, speaking of, you know, true crime documentaries, that I'm like, I can predict exactly what happens. And it's such and such in the hallway with a yes. knife. That's yes. that's what I was energy. Getting. but yeah, that's where it ends. Mm-hmm. And then we get the preview for kind of a preview for the Women Tell All next week. We didn't actually see any footage because I yeah. think they just filmed it. Mm-hmm. But then it looks like next week we're going to have one of those. They do this sometimes in Women Tell All where they combine it with like the rose ceremony
yeah.
of the fantasy suites or whatever episode they let us linger on. So it looks like next week we're going to find out what happens between Joey and Kelsey and mm-hmm. then maybe get a rose ceremony. I don't know. Maybe they'll delay it until the following
yeah,
week.
I don't know.
But it looks like we'll have answers. Maybe not. Maybe they'll make us wait until the next week. But I'm excited.
We're getting there.
Again, my prediction is that this note is being overhyped and it's going to be a pretty casual conversation between him and Kelsey, and that then we'll have all three women at the rose ceremony, and that he will send probably Rachel home. That's at least the vibe, unless they were doing editing magic on us. And then we're maybe going to be left with Kelsey and Daisy, but I don't think that Kelsey is going to go home.
Okay.
That's my guess. I think okay. they're over-dramatizing it. Now, I don't think they're over-dramatizing whatever happens at the end with the proposal. But I think right. this, they're trying to like lube us up sure, kind of. Like sure. it's going to be some big thing, but I don't think it's connected.
Okay.
Maybe.
Okay.
But maybe it is connected.
Yeah, I think she talks with him. She goes, I need to think about it. Then they're not allowed to talk until rose ceremony. She doesn't show up.
You don't think she shows up to no. the rose ceremony? Okay.
I think this note is the beginning of their
so then job. What are you is now your prediction for the remainder of the season if she doesn't show up?
Hold, what happens? Where are we at?
Fantasy Suites.
I know, but what happens next? Like, so I'm saying, like, how many more are there? Two episodes? Two.
No, typically just like one episode after Women Tell All.
One episode.
Yeah, and then in the after the final rose.
But then after the final rose. That's what I'm saying. So next week he gets on a knee.
Not next week, but the following week.
Okay. So what's next week? They just have like one
Women
more.
Women Tell All.
Right. So nothing happens though.
Right. Well, we find out the remainder of whatever this episode was.
Right. But nothing happens. There's not like another episode of
no,
stuff
no,
happening.
No, no,
so
no.
So that's
no.
my point.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You see where I'm going?
Yeah. I understand okay. what you're going.
So where do I just jump back in, or do we just make this the thing? Yeah, we just make this the thing yeah. because I was like, hold on, let's stop and talk about this. Am I losing my mind here? Okay. So all that being said, what I think happens is what I just said. In conclusion, I have said what I've said. It was really good seeing you guys.
No, what do you think happens? What do you think happens?
I said, like, they have this conversation.
No, I'm talking about the final when he's crying at the end.
They have this conversation. And then she goes, I need to think about it. Okay. But then they're not going to be allowed to see each other until the rose ceremony. She does not show up. So she thinks about it more and goes, no, I can't handle it.
There's another rose ceremony between Rachel, Kelsey. There's going to be a rose ceremony for the fantasy suites. And then they have... And then they meet Joey's family. And then they have the final altar one. We don't end it. It doesn't stop with three people.
Right. But I'm just saying like that. Okay. I see what you're saying. They talk.
Okay. She stays.
She stays. Then she leaves.
Okay.
But it's connected. I don't know if I can do this.
And she'll keep having that energy.
She'll keep. I don't know if I could do this. You know, it gets rid of Rachel or whoever. But I'm thinking Rachel. And then. You know, now the next thing is the get on the knee, right? In that interim,
okay.
It eats her more alive and okay. she leaves.
And you think that he's going to propose to her and then she doesn't show up?
No. Ooh. Yeah, because his crying was kind of intense, right? He would have just been like, oh, okay.
Like,
well,
what if,
a bummer.
Like, what if she doesn't show up and he wasn't planning on proposing to her?
Yeah, I don't know about that. I don't know who he's proposing to. I'm just saying she leaves.
Okay. All right. I like it.
Yeah,
we took a long way to get there, but we got there.
We got there. And this is kind of a look into our marriage, you know, it's just a real, like lots of weaving and, you know, then we're back and we find it and then I'm lost in what I'm saying. And then she's like, what are you talking about? And then we land the plane though.
We always land the plane. Well, I think my final prediction is going to be that she doesn't leave this week. And I think that she's going to be like told by him, like it's going to be like a confident, like, no, you're the one, but she's going to be doubting it. And then he's going to tell Daisy that she's not it, but not tell Kelsey.
And so then Kelsey won't screw himself.
And yes, and then Kelsey won't show up because she's like, I'm not sure. But then he's already gotten rid of Daisy, and she
that
doesn't
would be,
and she doesn't know that Daisy's gone. She thinks that Daisy's still there, and so she's like, oh no, I think it's gonna be Daisy, and so she doesn't show up. But he was planning on proposing. That's what I think is gonna
that
happen.
That would be
that's my guess.
Gnarly.
And they're both gone. Double elimination.
That
and
would
he's left
be,
with no one.
And then he's like, I dumped myself.
And then he's just a single guy. That's my guess.
Rough.
That's my guess, okay. Which would be really like depressing, but
a good guess. But a really guess. It was a creative. It was a creative guess.
Thank you so much.
Which I like. Mine that. Was just like, she leaves.
Don't know who he chooses.
Yeah. Mine was the worst. I apologize, and I talked the longest too about it. Oh
you
god,
talked
so long about the stupidest take you could ever have. Anyway, guys, I'm sorry. Apologies for this episode.
And then they will make Kelsey the next Bachelorette. That's my guess. That's my guess. Yeah. Now, you know, I love you, Kelsey. But I want Maria, who is our queen, who should be the next Bachelorette.
I'd be blown away if they did that.
But, you know, because Maria is the risky move, because Maria does what Maria does and what she wants. And we love that and live for that. But I think it might be one of those things where Kelsey doesn't show up to protect herself. Joey's devastated. And now everyone ends up single. And then Kelsey is our next Bachelorette.
Agreed.
And her father will be the next Golden Bachelor. And they will be the Bachelorette and Golden Bachelor simultaneously.
Wow. Like on double dates. I love that.
Yep. All right, fam. Love you all so much. Mwah. We'll see you Monday to talk about the Love is Blind reunion and et cetera, et cetera. All right. Love you.
Bye.
Bye.